Check out these new images from NASA of the moon. The Orion spacecraft snapped these pictures as it continues its Artemis 1 journey. A critical milestone just took place for the spacecraft. 10 days after lifting off from Kennedy Space Center, Orion is now entering a new historic orbit, which will take it into deep space.
West 2's Scott Heidler is live over on the Space Coast for us tonight. So, Scott, what happened today?
Well, this was just 40 minutes ago, and the Orion spacecraft had an 88-second engine burn that put it into this high orbit around the moon. Now, this is all part of what NASA says is a stress test for the craft. This distant retrograde orbit, or DRO, comes just a few days after Orion made its closest pass of the moon, just over 80 miles, and taking these amazing images of the lunar surface on Monday. And with this insertion burn, it'll be going farther than any other spacecraft designed for crew.
And so you have to design your spacecraft to handle the high radiation, both for your body, so that it won't give the crew radiation sickness, and also so the electronics on board the vehicle can handle the high radiation dose.
And not only are those doses of radiation higher with deep space missions, the exposure time will be longer as the missions will be farther. This also means the impact on equipment, communications, and navigation will be different than previous missions entering uncharted territory.
Generally, you don't know what you don't know. And we have to do these kinds of tests anytime you go to a new environment to let nature help us by showing us what the problems are, so that then all the bright engineers and scientists and technicians can solve those problems.
So Orion will be in this high lunar orbit until December 1st. It'll fire again after those 6 days, putting it on its path back to Earth. It'll splash down in the Pacific on December 11th. Reporting live in the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.